Though it started as a series about zombies, over time Resident Evil eventually became a series about bioweapons. And thanks to the endless creativity of Capcom and a multitude of viruses in the series canon, there's no shortage of monstrosities and bioweapons that players have come up against in Resident Evil across its many, many installments. From zombies and lickers to hunters and tyrants. From massive spiders to abyssal sea monsters. From the terrifying regenerators to the superpowered Albert Wesker. A quick note before we move forward. Please consider subscribing and enable all notifications by clicking the bell icon to get new video updates. And while you're at it, please click like if you enjoyed this video. It really helps us out. With that out of the way, let's begin. The abilities of bioweapons have been constantly escalating in Resident Evil at a gradual pace, but it wasn't until pretty recently that the series entered into the realm of flat-out mind control, which happened with Evelyn in 2017's Resident Evil 7. And though Ethan Winters managed to deal with her in pretty permanent fashion in that game, if there's one thing that the series has taught us over the years, it's that things, especially bioweapons, keep finding ways to come back in some way or the other. And so with Resident Evil Village not far away, here, we're going to recount the full story of Evelyn. The official designation given to Evelyn by her creators was E-001. As the name implies, she was the first iteration of the E-type bioweapon. Before we get into it exactly her story was, though, we need to go back in the series chronology to talk about the events that led up to her creation by the organization known as The Connections, a criminal syndicate that specializes in anything and everything to do with bioweapons. The experiments and research that would lead to the E-type BOW's creation started all the way back in 2000, with The Connections collaborating with HCF, who used to be one of Umbrella Corporation's biggest rivals back in the day, in their work based on fungus-based bioweapons. The Connections aimed to create a bioweapon with mind control abilities, and their work went on for several years before they started seeing results. After several iterations of the virus, it wasn't until sometime around 2014 that they landed on the E-type. Genetically created within a lab during the course of several experiments, E-001, or Evelyn, has various unique properties. For starters, The Connections artificially aged her and gave her the appearance of a 10-year-old child, figuring, and rightly so, that no one would believe a 10-year-old girl to be posing any kind of a serious threat, making her even more dangerous and efficient in her tasks and her abilities. On top of mind control, Evelyn was also able to vomit out large quantities of a black, gooey fungus-like substance called the mold, which she would use to create shambling monsters known as the molded. Evelyn did have a few limitations, of course. To maintain her mental stability and to ensure that she kept her physical appearance, The Connections would inject her with chemicals at regular intervals. Additionally, as they had done with all the iterations of BOWs before her creation, The Connections had fail-safes and contingencies in place to counter her as well, including a necrotoxin made using her tissue samples which could be used to neutralize her should the need arise. Out of Evelyn's most unique traits, however, was something that The Connections hadn't really intended, which was her desperate search for a family. Her personality became that of a troubled young girl, and she would obsessively look for people to fit into familial roles for her, as she looked for people to turn into her surrogate family members through her abilities. According to The Connections researchers, one of two things could be the reason for this. Either she knew that being part of a family unit would make her that much more efficient at infiltration of enemy groups and organizations, thus making her better at her task, or, and this seemed the more likely reason, she was desperately searching for the love and familial bond that she had completely lacked during her entire life. Of course, even with these caveats, the implications of the abilities and powers that Evelyn possessed was terrifying, or impressive depending on how one looked at it. Thanks to her mind control abilities, not to mention the ability to create small armies of molded bioweapons, Evelyn could infiltrate, dismantle, and control everything from enemy militaries to organizations to societies with deadly efficiency. If she could do all of it without the risk of collateral damage or the financial and economic disruption that more traditional weapons and violent bioweapons usually led to. All of this meant that by the time she was created, rival factions and opposing organizations had become aware of The Connection's latest creation, and were acutely aware of the threat that posed to them. Knowing that they had to protect what had become their greatest asset at all costs, The Connections tasked two of their agents to hide Evelyn away from the world. Agents Alan Droney and Mia Winters were tasked with traveling with Evelyn under the guise of her father and mother, respectively, to avoid suspicion, and take her to one of the Connection's labs in Central America. Their voyage aboard the tanker Annabelle proved to be quite eventful, however. The ship was wracked by a furious hurricane mid-voyage, and that caused Evelyn to lose control of her powers and lash out. She sprayed molded all over the tanker, killed most, if not all, of the crew, and infected Alan and Mia. The ship was wrecked, and by the time the wreckage washed up in the bayous of Dulvey, Louisiana, the only people that were aboard who managed to survive were Evelyn and Mia Winters, the latter of whom had lost consciousness. And that one fact proved to be fatal for a lot of people. Because Evelyn and Mia were found by a local man named Jack Baker, who took them to his family's estate nearby. Given the fact that Mia was unconscious, she was unable to tell the Bakers about Evelyn and her powers, and within 2 weeks, Evelyn had completely transformed the Bakers. Her deadly obsession with creating a family for herself led to infecting and exerting control over the entire family, turning them into mental slaves who were forced to do her bidding. One of them, Lucas Baker, eventually managed to break free from her control when he was recruited as an agent of the Connections and given a serum to regain his mental state. Lucas, however, managed to fool Evelyn into thinking that he was still acting under her commands as he conducted his own work with his new employers. Meanwhile, by 2017, due to the lack of regular medication provided by the Connections, Evelyn's artificial aging had accelerated rapidly, and though she eventually managed to stabilize herself, by the time she managed to do so, she had taken on the form of an old woman in a wheelchair. Over the course of the 3 years between 2014, which was when the tanker's wreckage washed up in Dulvey, and 2017, under orders from Evelyn, the Bakers would go on to abduct a number of people, most of them homeless or tourists, and some who had been encroaching on the Bakers' property. The purpose of all of these abductions was to find new members of Evelyn's family, but pretty much every single one of them failed to qualify and were either killed or turned into one of the molded. During this period of time, Mia had lost her memories of the circumstances leading to her and Evelyn's arrival at the Baker's residence almost entirely. But through Mia, Evelyn saw an opportunity to add another member to her family. Under Evelyn's control, Mia sent a message to her husband, Ethan Winters, who had believed his wife to be dead for 3 years, and told him to come to the Baker's residence in Dulvey to find her there. Ethan was shocked to hear from his supposedly dead wife, of course, and dropped everything to rush to Louisiana and reunite with Mia. Ethan Winters, however, proved to be a thorn in Evelyn's side, and turning him into one of her mental slaves proved to be a challenge for her. After arriving at the Baker's estate, Ethan not only managed to kill most of the Bakers, he also cured Mia of her infection. The two of them hopped aboard a boat and escaped, but while they were sailing past the Annabelle's wreckage, Evelyn used her mold to crash their boat, rendering both of them unconscious. She took Ethan captive, and it was here that Mia regained her memories. Determined to put an end to Evelyn's activities once and for all, she retrieved one of her tissue samples and managed to find and rescue Ethan. With the help of the tissue sample, Ethan created an E-necrotoxin, and using that, as well as with the help of a squad sent by Blue Umbrella and led by none other than Chris Redfield, Ethan was able to kill Evelyn. She put up a serious fight, of course, and her final form saw her merging with all of the mold she had spewed throughout the Baker residence, and grew to an enormous size, but Ethan was able to kill her after an intense fight nonetheless. And now, as we prepare to step into Ethan's shoes for Resident Evil Village once again, it's clear that Evelyn herself is not going to return. She's dead, after all. But that doesn't mean that the story of the E-type bioweapon is finished. The Connections are still very much around, and there's every chance that we might run into more molded BOWs again in Village. Meanwhile, though Mia was cured of her infection, there's the possibility that her and Ethan's daughter has traces of the virus still left in her, and maybe that's why Chris seemingly kills Mia and abducts their daughter. Either way, with Resident Evil Village not far away, we'll know the answers to these questions soon enough. And that brings us to the end of the video. A quick request before we conclude. We upload new videos every single day, and if you like what we're doing, please consider subscribing. It really, really helps us out. Also, don't forget to enable all notifications by clicking the bell icon so that you can receive daily video updates. Thanks for watching.